I am cutting this banana plant again and again for the last 6 months, but it keep on growing back for the last 6 months. The average lifespan of a banana tree is around 25 years, so does it mean it will keep on growing back for 25 years, on cutting it, or till it bears its fruit? A banana plant repeats this cycle of growth and death several times, until its rhizome no longer produces productive plants. Banana trees do die after harvest, but as the banana is a perennial plant, which replaces itself as an offshoot from the roots of the parent tree, the young pulps that emerge from the base of the plant, which I am cutting every week, can grow up to a full banana plant and will die after giving its fruit, and as we cut down the old parent plant, new offshoot will come up and will keep on repeating it for 25 years. To kill a banana plant is not that easy, as it keeps on growing back until we remove all the suckers and rhizome that may sprout around the base. We can dig up the rhizome entirely, but I am applying a chemical herbicide to kill the root, or we can kill a banana plant by filling a cut stalk with kerosene. I am cutting all these banana plant because these banana plants grows very tall, which crosses more than 30 to 40 feet and touches the electric power line, as you can see in this video. As I have a balcony which the banana plant leaves touches after touching the electric power lines, and it seems very dangerous to let the plant grow in such a dangerous condition, especially during the rainy season. Plants don't generally get electrocuted, as the electric current flowing through the plant passes into the earth in electro-culture. But wet plants during rainy season may get electrocuted. Plants are rather superconductive to electricity due to the salts and minerals in the fluid which circulates in the vascular system of a plant, consisting chiefly of water with dissolved sugars and mineral salts. Therefore, electric fences can't harm many plants. However, plants can be electrocuted on coming in contact with a high voltage power line, but this doesn't happen often. All living plants are conductors of electricity, and dead plants can also conduct electricity only during raining or wet conditions. In 1746, a Scotland scientist, Dr. Mainbray, noticed the rapid growth of plants stimulated by electricity, and since then many countries are studying the effectiveness of the method. After studying, it was found that a plant can grow faster and healthier using electrical stimulation, and many countries are using electrocution to boost crop production. This electroculture procedure can boost a plant growth by up to 30% by increasing absorption of calcium, potassium, and other vital nutrients by the plants, and defend the plant against microbial attacks.